Hi, welcome back to The Shtick, and we're in the studio with Colin Krycer OAM.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Yeah, we just have to wish you first off Mazel Tov.
Thank you.
In the Australia Day honours.
Yes, that was quite a surprise.
You thought it was a hoax.
Yeah, initially I was sent, this was last year, September last year, I received
really?
An email saying you've been nominated and would you like to accept the nomination, and I thought, no, someone's playing a joke on me. This is not real, because all the correspondence is done by email, and the email was formatted very badly when it appeared on my computer, and I thought, no, this is not real. So I sort of
spam.
I put it to one side and didn't think about it until the follow-up email, and that's when I realised it was real.
Fantastic. Anyway, you got it for services to the LGBTQI plus community.
For probably nearly 40 years of doing things for various organisations within the LGBTIQ plus community.
You've been working with the Thorn Harbour Health?
Yes, Thorn Harbour Health, which used to be known as the Victorian AIDS Council. And
right.
I've been with them 37 years and started doing hands-on care for people who had HIV/AIDS, so, you know, that's social outings and just taking them to doctor's appointments and things like that. And so that's where I started my LGBTI community work, with Thorn Harbour Health.
Wonderful. And you also were involved with the radio station as well.
Ah, the radio station, which is now 30 years old.
Oh.
I was there from day one. We're talking about Joy 94.9, which is one of very, very few LGBTIQ radio stations in the world. And we've now been going 30 years, which is absolutely incredible, and going very strong. So I'm one of the original members. I was on air for many, many years with my disco show. And
Disco on the Run.
Disco on the Run.
Oh, fantastic.
And it was a Saturday night.
That'd
disco
be so
show.
Much fun.
You know, if you like Village People and, you know, Donna Summer and that sort of thing, those songs will never die.
Never. And so what I really wanted to talk to you was about the Gay Pride March on Sunday.
Yes.
Which you and Michael Barnett, also OAM.
Yes.
You both run it under the Aleph label.
Well, yeah, we call it Jews of Pride.
Yeah.
So the whole contingent is under the umbrella of the Jews of Pride name.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a very successful day in March on last Sunday, despite the heat. We must push on regardless of the weather, and which is what we did. We had roughly, there would have been 150 in our contingent and representing all aspects of the Jewish community, not just LGBTI organisations, but youth groups and you name it, they were there, like synagogues. And
Namely TBI, Melbourne. Yeah. Melbourne Holocaust Museum, Habonim, Pathways, Jay Greens, Jewish Lesbian Group.
Everybody's there.
SCIF, Anti-Defamation Commission.
That's right.
JCCV, Kolenu, Anetza, just to name a few.
And they were all marching behind our sound truck, and we're playing, you know, Israeli music as loud as we could. And everyone was really proud of being there and you know, showing everybody that, you know, we're one, now I'm stuck for words. We're very inclusive.
Inclusive. Not
only for LGBTI, but all various aspects of our Jewish community. So we're represented very well.
Wonderful. Yeah, well, one of the controversies we've had since October the 7th, which has been very much slammed by a lot of the leftist, you know, the woke people, is the pro-Palestinian contingents. And one of the craziest things is the Queers for Palestine, which has been slammed, you know, because we tell them, hey, guys, you go to Gaza
and
see what...
Try that over there and see what happens.
Yeah,
that never ceases to amaze me. But very interestingly, this year in the Pride March, there was a Middle Eastern entry, which there hadn't been, to my knowledge, at all, except for one year we had some members of the Middle Eastern gay group join Aleph when Aleph marched as a group.
Really?
That was many, 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 many years ago. But this year they went out on their own, and they also had the big speakers with the Middle Eastern music and lots of Arabic
flags.
Well, there was the Palestinian flags, Lebanese flags, and so they were participating this year for the first time that I know of as a group.
Well, I have a very positive outlook on this, and I think that after all the war that we're going through now, and if we can eradicate Hamas, there'll be a lot less pushback against gays. Because if you look at Iran and many other countries in the Middle East, they don't allow any, I mean, Russia doesn't either.
No.
So there are lots of countries where people can't go out in the streets.
There's no such thing as a gay Russian. They don't exist.
No.
No, no.
Apparently not.
Apparently not.
They're all hidden in closets.
Yeah.
Still.
But hopefully things will change for the LGBTI Palestinians, and they can be more out than they are now. Well, they can't be out now, but
no.
Let's hope that changes.
And what happened this year was the protesters, the anti-police protesters, made a violent attempt to make their point.
Very disappointing to see. Look, Melbourne loves a protest. And I'll join in a protest as well, and I have done many with equal love and, you know, gay marriage and all that sort of
thing. If there's a cause.
Yeah. But not with violence.
No.
And that was premeditated, you know, paint bombs they brought with them, and they knew what they were going to do. And it's very upsetting to see that such a joyous occasion like the Pride March turns into what it did.
Yeah.
And especially with children around, and it's not a good...
Oh, yeah, they caused a horrible ruckus, and it's become a very unfortunate situation, hopefully, you know, if you're throwing paint bombs around, that's obviously premeditated.
It's very premeditated. Yeah, you don't make paint bombs up in while you're in the crowd waiting for the parade to pass.
No. So anyway, let's call it an unfortunate incident.
Very unfortunate.
Yeah, and we'll just carry on with life and be proud to be to have the gay rights that we have, and the Gay Pride Centre in Fitzroy Street is a phenomenal headquarters for...
Absolutely incredible building, which has won many architectural awards in the short time that it's been up.
I know. I've been inside, and it's just wonderful the way it's been
Once you get past that front door, it's like, whoa.
I know. It's incredible. Yeah. I know Daniel Andrews really made an effort to get you guys on side.
Mm.
And so it's been really fantastic to have you on the show, and Mazel Tov again on OAM.
Thank you.
And Michael Barnett has sent me a clip which we're going out
The
entire group coming through.
Yes.
And it was very colourful, very bright, very happy.
Well, I tell you what, the people that were watching from the sides absolutely loved us.
Yeah.
And they were cheering and clapping, and it was just really heartwarming to see that how accepted we were, and, you know, just it was really lovely, a wonderful experience, absolutely wonderful.
Yeah, well, good luck with the rest of your career as a volunteer.
As a volunteer.
Career as a volunteer.
Because I'm retired now.
Yeah, wonderful to see you. And we'll be back next week with more shtick.
I look forward to it.
Please watch us on YouTube, Channel 31. We're all over the place.
We say shalom.
Shalom.